file transfer protocol is one of those things that's been around for forever. In fact, the original RFC was written in 1985, so that'll give you some understanding. And it's a great protocol. It works. You can move files from here to there with relative ease. The problem is it's completely insecure. That means your username, your password, all of your commands, including your files, are sent in plain text, which, although very efficient and speedworthy, is incredibly insecure. Now, over the years, they've added stuff like FTP over SSL and FTP over SSH, which are both great extensions and actually beef up the power of the FTP protocol. The problem is they all require an additional client. And let's be serious, if you just have a one-off where you need to send a large file to someone or you need to request a large file from somebody, you don't want to have them have the overhead of learning how to use a new client. So for me, this is where SolarWinds Serv-U managed file transfer really, really works. So let me go ahead and show you what it looks like when you request a file. So after you log into the web portal, you can just go to Request Files. This is where you build the request. So let's go ahead and give it a detailed name. We'll call it Video Uploads. We can give it a comment if we like. We can put in some contact information, including whether or not to notify me when files have been uploaded. I can also have Serv-U directly send to the recipients, but I'm going to skip that for now. Next, we define the expiration, and I'm going to leave this link available for 14 days. Optionally, we can restrict the file sizes and also require an additional password if necessary. But in my example, I'm not going to do that. So let's go ahead and just build the request. And this is the URL we can use to share. Because I didn't define actual guest accounts, this is basically open to anybody. Anyone who has this particular link can upload files to your share, which is great, especially if you're going to do a large solicitation. If it's only going to one person, then I'd probably recommend go ahead and put that person's address in the guest field. And this page is what will be presented to anybody who actually uses this link. And because it's a web page, everyone already knows how to work with it. So we can just go ahead and browse for a file. Let's just grab one here and upload. And there we go, that file's been uploaded. If I want to add additional files, I can just do send more files and keep adding to the list. Now that's great if you want to solicit files from other people outside your organization. Now if you want to do the reverse and share these files with people outside your organization, you can also do that. So let's go back to the console. So just like before, from the console, go ahead and hit send files this time. So let's say for this example that you are going to share a large installer file with somebody. So let's go ahead and assign a subject. Again, fill in the contact information and email addresses if you want notification, and then fill in the guest email addresses. Or, like before, I'm going to uncheck this so I get a link. Let's go ahead and put an expiration of 7 days. Then we go next, and then we select our files that we'd like to share with external parties. So we hit browse, files on my computer. You can add more if you like, and then upload. Once the files are uploaded, you're presented with another link. So you can go ahead and copy this and share it with the people who you want access to that particular file. And if you open that link, there it is, the product installer. You can go ahead and check the box and download. So in a couple of minutes, I showed you how to request files from parties and also how to share files with parties. And this is great and just a very small feature set available in Serv-U MFT Server.